This tutorial will show how to seamlessly transfer a model from Revit structure to ETABS and then back again to Revit using CSiXRevit. This typically is the recommended direction for model data transfer. CSiXRevit allows materials, steel and concrete frame sections, walls, floors, and loads to all be exported from a Revit structure analytical model into ETABS. The model may then be modified, analyzed, and designed in ETABS, and then re-imported back into Revit structure with the changes. We start by opening a project in Revit structure. Note that CSiXRevit and Revit structure must be installed on the same computer, and Revit structure should be installed first. With CSiXRevit installed, the add-in file loads four commands, which we can find under the External Tools drop-down in the Add-ins tab. The four commands are export to create new, export to update existing, import to create new, and import to update existing. Our model has concrete columns, beams, slabs, and walls. All these will be exported to ETABS. If we scroll down to the families, we can see the sections that are available for the columns. These will be exported into ETABS. Let's take a closer look at the corner column. Note that it is a 450mm diameter round column. We will revise this column size in ETABS and then re-import. Also note that the roof edge is a straight line. We will modify this in ETABS to be a curved edge. Note that the CSiXRevit exports the analytical model from Revit structure, so let's switch our view to the structure analytical model. Note that in addition to the structural objects previously discussed, the loading is now also visible. This loading will be transferred to ETABS as well. Now let's export the model to ETABS. Using the Add-ins tab and the External Tools panel, we select the Export to Create New ETABS model. We will leave all options checked to send all objects to ETABS. We will name the export file revit_ETABS. It has the extension .exr. Next, we will open the log file that CSiXRevit created. This file has the extension .exr log, and it lists the version numbers, which should be the same, and error messages, if there are any. In our case, we have no errors. Now, with ETABS running, we will import the file just created by CSiXRevit. We go to the file, Import Revit Structure command. And select the Revit ETABS file. ETABS gives a listing of the items being imported. We will make no changes here. with import complete, ETABS displays a plan view and a 3D view of the model. We will turn off the grid lines to simplify our views. In the 3D view, we will extrude the frame objects. And spin the model to get a better view of the corner where we are going to modify the column. However, before we make any changes, let's look at the properties that have been imported using CSiXRevit. First of all, the material properties from Revit are present. Next, we will look at the frame objects. Remember that the corner column we will modify is a 450 mm circular section. If we look at the universal columns, which are steel sections, we see that this is an auto-select list containing all of the UC sections. The slab sections have also been imported. As has the wall section. The load patterns have been created. And a right-click on a floor shows that on the Loads tab that the live load has been applied as well. Turning off the extruded frames option, we next right-click on the corner column that we wish to modify. We are going to revise the column to be a 600 mm circular section. Next, we are going to modify the roof deck to have a curve at one edge. We select the roof and click the Edit, Edit Shells, Modify Slab Edge Type command. And select Edge 6. This is the edge we are going to modify. We are going to change the edge type to circular curve with a radius of 90 meters. The center point on the left side and the curve to the right side. Note how the edge now has a curve to it. We are now ready to run the analysis in ETABS. This message from ETABS tells us that we should check our warning file, which we will do upon completion of the analysis. With the analysis complete, we will animate the display shape in the 3D view. Note how our canopy roof is moving. It appears that certain elements were not correctly connected in Revit. This is a common problem when creating models in a CAD environment. Next, let's take a look at the warning file created. The warning file tells us that floor area F2 has a meshing issue. Returning to ETABS and using the Select by Labels command, and then selecting Shell F2, we see that the warning file has identified the canopy roof we just discussed. The warning file has identified the same connectivity issue. Thus, it is important to check the warning files each time an analysis is run. ETABS also allows us to display all the forces, such as moment diagrams. Next, we will run the design for concrete frames. Zooming in, we see the longitudinal reinforcing in our modified column. A right-click, and then clicking the Summary button, shows us the design sheet. Note that the column ID is shown as 600 millimeters. We are now ready to export the model back out for Revit Structure. Clicking the File, Export, Revit Structure command, we will name the exported file ETABS Revit. With Revit Structure running and our project open, we go to the Add-ins tab and click on the Import to Update Existing command under the External Tools. And select the ETABS Revit file. We will update all of the objects. A quick look at the mapping options for frames shows how the sections are mapped from ETABS to Revit Structure. Note our 600 millimeters section. We will also update both the locations and designs. With the model updated, we will return to the architectural view. Clicking on our modified column, note that the column now shows up as a 600 millimeter column, as modified in ETABS. Switching to a plan view, note that the roof deck is now curved, again as modified in ETABS, thus confirming that CSiXRevit allows the transfer of curved geometry. As a final step, we will again review our log file. The log file now shows both the export from Revit and the import back to update the Revit structure project. And because we performed an update rather than created a new project, the log file shows the changes that were made to the project. This completes this tutorial on CSiXRevit.